tomorrow on the 12:30 Star movie, you'll never believe what happens when a pair of moonlighting cops get taken for a ride by a gang of car crooks in Double Nickels on Channel 11.
In mid-December, the Citizens Budget Commission, one of the city's oldest and most respected watchdogs, entered the argument about how New York City should spend its expected budget surplus, with the suggestion that the funds be used to pay for items in the capital budget. Among those who agree with the Budget Commission are Comptroller Harrison Golden and City Council Finance Committee Chairman Edward Sadowski. On the side of using the money for improved services are the mayor, the city's budget director, and City Council President Carol Bellamy. Sitting on the fence is a whole host of local politicians waiting to see how public sentiment develops. The arguments are classic. One side says New York needs to replace more of the services which were lost during the fiscal crisis of the 1970s. They see the budget surplus as a perfect opportunity to do that. The other side says the city can save billions by using the budget surplus each year to pay for items in the capital budget, items that otherwise would be financed by bonds, which now carry relatively high interest rates. The management of WPIX understands the political appeal of increasing services in an election year, but we and other New Yorkers would be more impressed with candidates who took the Citizens Budget Commission advice, which says the city can save more than $3.25 billion over the next 9 years by using only $200 million each year of surplus money for capital projects. That's an offer that's just too good to pass up, even for political reasons. What's your opinion? We'd like to know.